nice, some home. Both good news and bad news. The bad news is, I thought I was going to be getting my 3D printed lightsaber today, but my friend, poor guy, he's been having problems with that 3D printer for the last 3 days. He's got 3 projects all backed up because of it. And it looks like he needs a new nozzle on the 3D printer. So it could be probably another 2 weeks before we get to see the 3D printing of my lightsaber. So, oh well. But the good news is I was able to pick up quite a bit of stuff today as I was out shopping. Some of it was kind of an impulse buy, but it was inexpensive, so. Oh, she's curious about it too. Hi, Manali. You little. She thinks she smells food in there, but there's nothing edible. They've always got books for sale at the library, and I was able to pick up 4 for like $2, because they're like 50 cents each for paperbacks, even something this big. And oh, and this one's one of my favorites too. But I was able to do that. So I got some books. This was a big find. I went to the local thrift store that we have out here. In this area, we do not have Goodwill or Salvation Army. We do have Deseret Industries, which is run by the Mormon Church. But they are the best thrift store I've ever been to. Their prices and selection and quality and helpfulness are through the roof. So, surprise, I found a queen-sized flat sheet over there, ivory-colored. It looks like it's in fairly good shape. For $3. I'm not kidding. And this is going to do perfect for the definitive version of my Endor Leia poncho. It's really soft, too. But, yeah. Oh, and this is good material, too. It's not see-through. So, yeah, this is quite a find, and I'm very, very happy with that. As a point of comparison, the fabric I was going to get for the definitive version of the Endor Leia poncho would have been $30. So, yeah, I paid $3 for this. Steal. Next thing I got is also toward Endor Leia. I got some paint. This is just regular spray paint, but it bonds to, you know, a whole bunch of different things, so I figure any porous material would work. People have used this on fabric before without too much of a problem, but I got something like an olive green, it's called oregano, and a dark green, it's called hunter green, and a bright green. So, yeah. This was not very expensive, and I figured this ought to fill in nicely for painting the camouflage colors on the original, my temporary version. And the other thing I got was a bunch of acrylic paint. Oh, and some tape. I've been out of transparent tape for like a couple of months, and I've had a tear on one of my posters. I've been dying to repair it. Now I can do that. And yeah, I got 6 different colors of acrylic paint. And this is not for any costumes. This is for painting different characters for my little Halloween / harvest lawn decoration. So there we go. That's what I've been up to today. I went shopping. I was also able to get in a little bit of driving practice, which was cool. And this time I got to drive a Jeep instead of a van. Sorry I didn't take the GoPro along, but there wasn't a mount for it, and the little clip has been messed up for a while, but there we go. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching. There's a lot of stuff coming. I got stuff to catch up on. I will be doing a reaction video tomorrow instead of tonight. So until next time, this is the Clumsy Jedi signing off. Good night, folks.
Besides, nobody likes a clumsy Jedi.
Clumsy.